हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम टू डीएवी मॉयल पब्लिक स्कूल। लेट्स बिगिन एन ऑनलाइन सेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 10th मैथमेटिक्स विथ योर टीचर मिसेज वंदना घाघरे। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन द लेसन पेयर्स ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल वी विल सी ग्राफिकल मेथड ऑफ सॉल्विंग पेयर्स ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल्स। In the previous session, we have seen which type of equations are called pairs of linear equations in two variable. Today we will see something more about the equations. A pair of linear equations which has no solution at all is called an inconsistent pair of linear equation. Because we have seen three possibilities of the line, intersecting lines, parallel lines and the coincident lines. Based on that, we will get here now different conditions on the solutions. So first one is a pair of linear equations which has no solution is called an inconsistent pair of linear equation. A pair of linear equation in two variable which has a solution is called a consistent pair of linear equations. A pair of linear equations which are equivalent and has infinitely many distinct common solutions, such a pair is called a dependent pair of linear equations in two variables. Note that a dependent pair of linear equations is always consistent. We can now summarize the behavior of lines representing a pairs of linear equations in two variable and the existence of solution as follows. Now first condition, the lines may intersect in a single point. This is the case when we are taking the intersecting lines. In this case, the pairs of equations has a unique solution. Unique solution means only one solution, and this type of equations are called consistent pair of equations. So intersecting lines are consistent pair of equations. The lines may be parallel. We have seen in a plane two lines may be parallel. So when the lines are parallel, in this case the equation has no solution is at all, means no common values of the variable in between these two, because these solutions, these lines are parallel lines, never intersect with each other, and therefore this type of equations are called inconsistent pairs of equations. The lines may be coincident. In this case the equations may have infinitely many solutions. This type of condition is also called consistent pair of equation. And one more is that dependent type equation. So we have seen three types of conditions based on the lines. If the lines are intersecting, how many solution? Only one, and the system is called consistent. If the lines are parallel, means no solution, and the system is called inconsistent. And if many, infinitely many solutions are there, lines are coincident, then that type of lines are called consistent lines, but special name dependent also. Let's now go back to the pairs of linear equations, and here three examples are there. If you will see the first example and plot the points, the graph shows the lines are intersecting lines. Second example, graph shows lines are coincident lines. And the third example, graph shows the lines are parallel lines which never intersect. Now we can conclude the intersecting lines means how many solution? Just now we have seen, dear students, yes, the intersecting line means one solution. Coincident line means many solution, infinitely many solutions. And parallel line means no solution at all. Now we will compare the coefficients of these three equations. So what are the coefficients of these equations? In general, in common, if you will see, a1, b1, c1 is the coefficient of one line, and a2, b2, c2 is the coefficient of another equation. So we will see the different conditions which are based on these coefficients. See here, if you will take the coefficients a1 upon a2, the answer is 1 upon 3, because here a1 is equal to 1 and a2 equals to 3. So a1 upon a2 equals to 3. b1 upon b2, b1 b2 means coefficients of y. So take their ratios, minus 2 upon 4. c1 upon c2, coefficient of, that is constant term. So it is 0 upon minus 20. Compare the ratios, a1 upon a2 here, not equal to b1 upon b2. Now, when this condition is there, a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2, the graphical representation shows the lines are intersecting lines. And intersecting line means, what is the algebraic interpretation? Intersecting line means exactly one solution is there, means unique solution. In this way, without plotting the points on the graph, just by comparison of the coefficient, we can find out how many solutions does the pairs of linear equation has. See now the second equation, second pairs of linear equation. Again here, take the coefficients and their ratio. a1 upon a2 equals to 2 by 4. b1 upon b2 equals to 3 by 6. c1 upon c2 equals to minus 9 upon minus 18. Now if you will see here and simplified it, all these three ratios are equal. In the previous case, first two ratios are unequal. In the second case, all three ratios are equal. So when you will get all three ratios are equal, the lines, when you plot, you will see the lines are coincident line. And coincident line means, what is our algebraic interpretation? It is infinitely many solutions are there. System is what? System is consistent. You can also call it as a dependent. See the third case. And again you compare the coefficients. Here a1 upon a2 equals to 1 by 2. b1 upon b2 equals to 2 by 4. Which is also in turn becomes 1 upon 2. And c1 upon c2 equals to minus 4 upon minus 12. If you will compare the ratios, a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2, not equal to c1 upon c2. So when this type of condition is there on the end, without plotting the points on the graph, you can tell the lines are parallel lines, and parallel line means no solutions at all. So dear students, what you have to remind here, you have to remind here the comparison ratio. Again I will repeat, if it is, take the ratio, find out all three ratios of the equations. If a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2, lines are intersecting lines. If all three ratios are equal, lines are coincident lines. And if ratios are equal and is not equal to third ratio, that is c1 upon c2, then the lines are parallel lines. One example, the number of skirt is 2 less than twice the number of pants purchased. Also, the number of skirt is 4 less than 4 times the number of pants purchased. So here first, we will frame the equations. The equations are y is equal to 2x minus 2 and y is equal to 4x minus 4. Then we will find out two solutions for each of the equation, and then we will plot the points. Here on the graph you can see the line is what? intersecting lines. So the system is consistent and the solution is the point where both the lines intersect with each other. So here Q equals to 1, 0 is the solution of these two intersecting lines. In this way, we have to find out graphically also whether the lines are coincident lines, parallel lines, or intersecting lines, or just by the comparison of the ratio, you can also guess and interpret the whether the lines are parallel, intersecting, or coincident. See here one more example. Here we have to check whether the pairs of equations has no solution, unique solution, or infinitely many solution. First equation is already in the simplified form. Now we will solve the second equation. When you solve the second equation, again you will get the same equation which is as the first one. Now, if you will compare the ratios A1 upon A2, B1 upon B2 and C1 upon C2, you will see all three ratios are equal. And when all three ratios are equal, what we can say, what we can interpret? We can interpret the lines are coincident line, and coincident lines have infinitely many solutions. If you are not satisfied, dear students, take the graph paper and start find the solutions for equation, two solutions, and then plot the points. You will get two lines, but the lines are coincident. From the above example, we can observe that the lines represented by the equations, that is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals to 0. a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2, means we have to first take the ratios of their coefficient. So the lines are intersecting lines if a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2. Lines are coincident line if all three ratios means a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 is equal to c1 upon c2. And if the lines are parallel, then you will get the ratios like this. a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2, but it is not equal to c1 upon c2. So these are the three conditions on the coefficients, my dear students. Again and again I am telling you, you have to learn by heart these three conditions so that graphically and algebraically also you can interpret whether the lines are intersecting lines, coincident lines, and parallel lines. Today, dear students, we have learnt how to plot and interpret algebraically whether the pairs of lines are parallel lines, intersecting lines, or coincident lines. So here is a small examples as an assignment for you. So only you have to check whether the line are parallel line, coincident lines, or intersecting lines. Which lines has one solution, no solutions, or infinitely many solution? Which system is consistent and which is not? So all this you have to solve here in the assignment. Without graph, only by using the conditions on the coefficients, you can guess whether the line representing are intersect at a point, are parallel, or coincident. In the third question, whether the system is consistent or inconsistent. Now in this exercise, from the graph, means by plotting the graph, you have to find out whether the pairs of linear equations are consistent or inconsistent, and some word problems are given. Try to frame the equations and solid, whether it is graphically or algebraically, as per the given conditions of the problems. Thank you, dear students. Have a nice day.